服务湾区社群，关注世界大事，焦点访谈，
节目主持叶丽玲、麦长雄，节目直播热线650-808-8000 650-808-8000。
早晨，各位，时间好快嚟到咧9:12，咁啊，今日星期五嘅早上啊，我哋焦点访谈嘅节目非常之荣幸，能够咧就系请到啊三藩市历史上首位嘅亚裔市府律师邱信福上到嚟咧我哋节目嘅。
嗯，冇错，咁亦都系邱信福，亦都系我哋嘅老朋友啦。咁啊，曾经咧佢担任唔同嘅职务嘅时候咧，都经常上嚟同我哋系讲讲佢嘅政策啦等等。而今次咧就系翻到嚟三藩市做呢个市府律师，亦都系非常之厉害嘅一个啊职位嘅。咁所以翻会同佢倾倾呢个心路历程啦。咁亦都欢迎大家咧，除咗收听我哋嘅呢个星岛中文电台之外，亦都可以收睇我哋呢个星电视嘅 YouTube channel 嘅直播嘅，因为而家呢个直播已经开始咗噶啦。
系啦，咁啊，而家咧只要你打开咧 YouTube 星电视啊，咁就会睇到咧呢个小时我哋访问咧三藩市历史上首位嘅亚裔市府律师啊邱信福嘅。
嗯，冇错。咁呢个时候即刻同我哋嘅三藩市府律师邱信福打个招呼先啦。Good morning。
Good morning, City Attorney。
Good morning, 早晨，大家好。
啊，你啲中文进步咗好多、
啊。Getting much better.
In fact, I also just say to all our viewers, 新年快乐。
Oh yeah, it's coming. Next
month, yeah. 好快，好快。
Of course, thanks for having me back.
系啦，咁啊，想问翻咧，阿邱信福啦，咁啊，啊，可唔可以介绍一下，点解你会诶转咗岗位嘅咧？嗱，原本咧你就系州议员嚟噶嘛，点解会转咗，会诶突然之间会系成为呢个市府律师嘅咧？
Well, first of all, it was an incredible honor for me to serve as the legislator representing Eastern San Francisco in the California State Legislature over the last 7 years.There's a lot that we've been able to work on together, but I was very honored when 2 months ago, Mayor London Breed appointed me to be the city attorney and to become the first Chinese American city attorney. There are a number of reasons why I decided to change jobs, but you know, first and foremost, I have always been committed to the fight for justice. This is in part why I went to law school,became a civil rights attorney, became a criminal prosecutor, worked as a lawyer, and ultimately decided to run for office. And this job as the city attorney gives me the opportunity to continue that fight for justice.
咁啱，我想第首先反映，咁過去七年咧，我好榮幸咧喺我哋嘅加州嘅議會係代表我哋三藩市嘅東邊嘅。咁將市長布里德提出我去擔任第一位華人市府律師嗰陣時候咧，我真係覺得好難去拒絕佢啦。一個咁大嘅榮幸。咁我係決定去依一個新嘅辦公室咧，係因為我係好想繼續我生命力去爭取的正義的。咁我成為立法者之前咧，我都係喺法律界出身嘅。我係有擔任過民權律師啦，我有做過刑事嘅檢控官，美國參議院嘅法律顧問，同埋聯邦上訴法官嘅法律助理嘅。
嗯，咁我哋呢度咧都要介紹翻啦，差啲唔記得介紹我哋今日嘅翻譯啦。咁有阿 Michelle 喺度嘅，
係啦，多謝阿江曉彤咧做我哋呢個傳譯嘅，都佢而家優秀府辦公室一個好重要嘅一個員工啦，可以係咯係咯，好厲害嘅一個職位嚇。
係啦係啦，咁亦都歡迎大家咧有任何疑問咧，或者係你住喺三藩市嘅，咁當然有好多疑問咧要向我哋歷史上首位嘅亞裔市府律師咧就查詢嘅，咁可以咧利用短信平台咧就係將你嘅問題文字信息輸入。
冇錯，650-308-2208650-308。2208都是全程开放，大家特别是一些关于市府的一些法例的问题，大家如果有疑问的话，很欢迎打电话，即是文字短信上来啦。我们看到直播方面也有很多的网友已经在跟我们互动，如果大家可以是有问题想问关于我们三藩市本地的一些问题，都可以是跟我们互动一下的。
好了，继续我们是会跟这个邱信福就谈一下的。
回顾一下，其实因为知道在做这个市府律师之前，其实邱信福做过很多个不同的位置，譬如说市参事啦，州議員啦，
市參事主席啦，
係啊，市參事主席啦，係啊，咁所以其實有好多由地區啦，又去到呢個州議會啦，而家翻翻嚟咧就係市內邊，咁其實有唔同嘅一啲職業生涯咧，即係個政治生涯咧，都可以同大家回顧下咧喺呢個州議會嘅立法過程當中嘅一啲有趣嘅事情啦，同埋想同大家分享嘅嘢。
Well, so for the past 7 years, I've been serving in the state legislature, and as the first Asian American to represent Eastern San Francisco, fighting for our immigrant communities has been something that has been very important. And so, so I authored a number of laws to protect immigrant workers, immigrant tenants, to assist immigrant small businesses to be able to grow their businesses. And we also passed a law to assist immigrant students who are being bullied in the classroom. This has always been a big priority for me.
咁喺我過去依七年期間喺州議會度咧，我好開心，我係可以做第一個華人嘅代表去代表三藩市嘅。咁依段期間我係好努力去為我哋嘅社會去爭取權益啦。我同好多嘅唔同嘅州議員去訂立咗新嘅法例去保護我哋嘅移民嘅。工人、我哋嘅租客、小企業同埋我哋學生所喺堂上受嘅欺凌嘅。
嗯。
I also mentioned that during this past year of anti-Asian hate, I worked with my Asian colleagues, particularly Assemblymember Phil Ting, to pass the largest amount of money of any state to address anti-Asian hate. So about $156 million in the budget. Two-thirds of this money is going to go to assist victims and to also keep building up public safety programs in our community. The rest is going to go to help us track anti-Asian hate incidents, to help us collect data. And we also have some money in this for the ethnic media like Tsingtao, because we know that radio shows like this, your organization, mm-hmm. other news organizations are so critical at educating our community.
咁因為我哋疫情依兩年嚟咧，我哋面臨咗好多反亞裔嘅仇恨啦。我同丁友立議員咧係合作通過咗我哋嘅亞太裔平工預算案嘅。咁有三分二依一個預算案咧係為我哋嘅所受害者嘅服務啦，同埋繼續建立我哋嘅公共安全計劃。其餘嘅錢咧就係會愛嚟去搜集我哋嘅社區裏邊嘅反亞裔仇恨嘅事件啦，同埋。亦都會支持好似星島咁嘅少數民族嘅集體媒體。
嗱，我就想問翻邱信福啦，咁就係嗱，你由呢個三藩市嘅市參事啦，咁啊走到去呢一個州嘅議會，跟住又翻嚟，咁啊或者從你個由細嘅經歷到你呢、這個即係出嚟做事嘅經歷，你自己本身有冇遭受過乜嘢嘅？因為你亞裔身份遭受過啲咩歧視咁咧？
嗯哼。It's a really good question. So I am the son of Chinese immigrants. And when we were growing up, my family never really, we never talked about politics. And I certainly never thought I would become a lawyer because we didn't know any lawyers. We didn't know any politicians. And we also never really spoke about race
mm-hmm.
or civil rights issues. This is not what we discussed at the dinner table. But I will tell you, when I was a freshman at Harvard, there was this horrible incident that happened at a nearby university. There were eight Asian students that were going to a party, and they were attacked. I was asked, along with others, to come to their assistance. Turns out their attackers were never brought to justice, and it was very upsetting to me. And this is in part why I became a student activist, why I started studying the civil rights movement, why I decided to go to law school and enter a career public service.
咁我亦都係喺一個移民嘅家庭中長大嘅。咁我諗我哋好多嘅聽眾都一樣，係屋企人係唔中意去講政治啊，或者任何嘅種族嘅迫壓。咁喺依度變咗個常態啦，一路長大咁喺餐台上咧就會避免去迴避講依啲咁嘅話題啊。
迴避政治啦，
係啊，
係啊，父母最好我哋華人父母最好子女做醫生、律師啊、工程師，
都係做律師啊。
係啊，
咁但係佢哋屋企人就係唔好
從政，
唔好從政。 好唔好呢啲太過敏感嘅問題。咁、嗯、但係佢喺讀 Harvard 嘅期間咧，佢就係有八名嘅亞裔學生就係、是、遇到去跳舞嗰陣時候遇到俾人襲擊。咁最慘咧就係、是、襲擊佢哋嗰啲人咧係冇被繩之於法嘅。咁呢一個令到我係反映到哦，我可以變成其中呢一啲學生嘅，亦、都可以俾我去遇襲。咁我就係、是、同其他學生去組織咗去想爭取翻我哋應該所有嘅保護嘅保障嘅。
嗯哼，咁繼係咯，繼續咯，繼續等阿David講講。Anything to add？
Well, this is, you know, after that experience when I was in college, this is why I decided to represent immigrants as a civil rights attorney. It's why I decided to spend time as a criminal prosecutor. And it's why I thought that it was important to run for office because our community was so rarely represented in politics. We didn't have a seat at the table. And, you know, we're certainly seeing during this time of pandemic and recession,and anti-Asian hate, just how important it is for our community to be able to speak up and speak out. And this is why I wanted to come home as the first Chinese American city attorney to be able to continue to fight for our community.
所以呢我是擔任過做民權律師，做過檢察官的。我是真係想去從政，係因為我係睇到我哋嘅亞裔社會社區係冇任何嘅代表嘅，咁令到我，尤其是喺一個疫情裏邊咧，我哋嘅社區真係要有一個聲音，有人去代表我哋所要嘅嘢嘅。
嗯，好，咁呢個時間稍微要去廣告先，再翻嚟繼續咧，同我哋市府律師咧，邱順福咧，係繼續傾傾其他嘅話題。咁我哋嘅文字短信平台6501-300-2808咧，都係全線開放，等緊大家咧係發表你意見啦，又或者打電話上6501-80-8000啦。咁我哋呢個直播嘅呢個直播間亦都可以歡迎同大家互動嘅。
服務灣區社群，關注世界大事，焦點訪談。
节目主持叶丽玲、麦长雄，节目直播热线650-808-8000，650-808-8000。
好啦，继续今日焦点访谈啊！今日非常之荣幸咧，能够请嚟咧三藩市啊历史上首位嘅亚裔市府律师邱信福。咁成日都我哋都好熟噶啦，因为咧佢做历任呢个三藩市市参事啊主席嘅时候都经常上嚟，或者做呢个周议员嘅时候都经常上嚟噶啦。咁
啊，唔同嘅活动场合，我哋都会同阿邱信福有呢个交集啦、交流啦。
冇错，好咁呢个时候咧，我就想继续想问翻啊邱信福啦。咁就系好多时啊，嗱，几乎我哋都未必知道呢个分别嘅。咁就系三藩市个地检处同三。三藩市嘅市府律师究竟有啲咩分别咧？
系啦 ，Question number two。
So, what the city attorney's office does is really three things. First, we are the lawyers, the general counsels to over 100 city departments, commissions, and boards, as well as the lawyer to the mayor and every member of the board of supervisors. So, what that means is we're providing advice and legal counsel to everything from the airport to the zoo, from public health to public safety, our port system, our library, our transit system, parks, water, energy. Those are all the things that we provide advice in.
咁由我哋嘅市府律師嘅部門咧，係其實做三樣嘢嘅。第一樣咧就係、是、我哋會提供法律做一個法律顧問啦，為我哋所有嘅多個城市裏邊多過100嘅部門嘅。咁第二咧，我哋亦都會去為依啲部門同埋我哋九金山市同縣咧係做法律辯護嘅同埋代表。
The second thing we do is we defend and represent the city against thousands of lawsuits when they're brought against the city. So this could be, for example, when San Francisco was sued by the former president for the work we did for immigrants. We defended that lawsuit.
Okay. 比例咧就係、是、好似我哋上一任嘅總統就係唔中意我哋三藩市為唔同嘅移民嘅保障啦、保護啦，咁、
個移民政策
係啦，咁佢咧就係、是、告咗我哋三藩市嘅市府嘅，咁我哋嘅部門就係為我哋依一份嘅
即係有人告三藩市市府嘅時候咧，咁市府律師就要出嚟辯
護
啦，
係
啦，
And then the third thing we get to do is we have the power to bring lawsuits on behalf of the people of California. What that really means is when there are folks out there or companies that are engaged in unfair practices or fraud that somehow are victimizing San Franciscans, we can sue them. So it could be gun manufacturers. It could be we've recently sued opioid makers. We are suing to protect programs in San Francisco that assist our immigrant community. These are all things that we are fighting to protect.
咁市府律師咧，亦都有權咧去代表我哋加州嘅人民咧去提起訴訟嘅。咁如果即係有任何嘅公司啊，大公司係做啲不當嘅行為咧，去傷到我哋嘅公民咧，我哋可以去提起訴訟嘅。
咁但係譬如刑事方面咧，市府律師有權提出訴訟啦。咁但係譬如地檢署，佢哋都有權對一啲罪犯提出呢個起訴噶。咁會唔會嗰個權責方面有啲咩重複咧？
There's actually a lot of confusion that I've discovered in the last couple of months about the difference between the district attorney and the city attorney. The district attorney has responsibility for enforcing criminal laws. So anytime someone breaks the law when it comes to crime, right? Violent crime we see on the streets, other types of crimes, and that person is arrested, the district attorney is the one who makes decisions on whether to prosecute that. We handle all legal issues outside of the criminal justice system. And so if you think about everything that happens in city government that does not involve the criminal justice system, we're involved in that. And we are also the ones that are suing, say, big companies when companies owe San Francisco money. So it's in the civil context as opposed to the criminal context.
咁地檢官咧，佢哋係執行刑法嘅。咁如果真係有人為咗法，佢哋係打人啊，或者佢哋有偷到嘢啊，去違反咗個法例咧，就係地檢官去負責去控告呢啲人嘅。咁我哋係負責所有法律其他嘅嘢嘅，
即係刑事之外嘅其他案件咁樣。
係啦，係啦。
哦。嗱，咁亦都有啲聽眾咧，就係提問到啊，呢個問題係幾好嘅。有聽眾就問到啦，佢話好似有部分聽眾不滿呢個地檢官對於一啲嘅罪犯冇起訴，咁可唔可以轉移要求市府律師去對一啲罪犯提出起訴咧？咁樣。
So as I said before, the city attorney's office, our office, we do not have the power that the district attorney office does to prosecute. Perpetrators of crime, people who have been accused of crime. It's a different job. There are some things that we have been able to do to bring lawsuits against, for example, the manufacturers of opioids, which has been really fueling a lot of crimes we're seeing on the streets, as well as drug use that we're seeing on the streets. And so that's something that we are pursuing very aggressively. But when it comes to everyday street crimes, that's under the jurisdiction of the district attorney, not the city attorney.
So, 我哋係有權限嘅，咁所有刑事嘅嘢咧，我哋係冇得去提供任何嘅訴訟噶。我哋要留翻俾地檢官去做嘅。我哋所可以做嘅嘢咧，就係可以去控告一啲製藥嘅藥商，佢哋做出嚟嘅佢哋嘅藥品係害到我哋嘅社區嘅，但係喺任何喺街上邊、街頭上邊嘅暴力咧，我哋係冇能力去執行嘅。
即係個權責其實分得好清楚嘅。
係啦，係啦。
咁嗱，我就想問翻阿邱信福啦，咁你上任咗幾個月啦，目前你要優先處理嘅事項係乜嘢咧
？So I have a number of priorities. You know, first of all.In the last couple of years, we have seen so many challenges to different communities of diversity, communities of color, immigrant communities, and a lot of attempts to roll back the civil rights of these communities. We've certainly seen it in the Asian community when it comes to anti-Asian hate violence. And so one of my top priorities will be fighting to move forward our collective civil rights.
咁首先咧，我係而家我係見到喺我哋社區同埋好多其他嘅少數民族裏邊咧，佢哋嘅挑戰係有好多嘅佢哋嘅權益被剝削嘅。咁我最優先嘅就係想為我哋嘅集體公民權益而戰。
The second thing I'll say is we are in the midst of the biggest era of income inequality that our country and frankly the world has seen. And during this time period, I think it's important for us to be fighting for workers and consumers who are being taken advantage of in this economy. And so that'll be a second priority.
其次咧，咁喺我哋依一個好不平等嘅時代裏邊咧，我哋係見到好多嘅收入嘅不平衡。我哋嘅工人嘅權益同埋我哋消費者亦都俾人剝削嘅。
好，咁我哋先休息一陣間先，稍後翻嚟咧會繼續啊同啊市府律師邱信福咧繼續傾，亦都歡迎大家有問題嘅話，
係啦，文字短信650-382-2808，650-382-2808，或者打電話上650-8088000嘅，我哋最後翻嚟繼續傾過。
服务湾区社群，关注世界大事，焦点访谈，
节目主持叶丽玲、麦长雄，节目直播热线650-8088000，650-8088000。
咁時間嚟到9:37，我哋今日嘅繼續今日嘅焦點訪談，咁咧都係同阿 Ken 講翻聲，因為咧見到咧喺 YouTube 直播上好多聽眾咧就有留言嘅，咁佢哋以為今日咧，咦係咪總編輯時間啊？唔係，總編輯時間係琴日。
冇錯，咁但係咧，我哋都不定時會有唔同嘅呢個直播嘅呢個節目啦，咁所以大家唔需要擔心嘅，咁亦都歡迎大家繼續係收睇我哋呢個星電視嘅直播。
係啦，亦都希望或者大家每一日都上9:00嘅時候，我哋呢個時間9:00上一上 YouTube 睇下有冇直播啊嘛。係
啦，冇錯冇錯。
好，咁呢個時候咧，我哋繼續同阿邱信福傾過。有些聽眾要利用電話，希望可以跟我們的市府律師談一談，有位劉太，劉太請說。
你好啊，
請說劉太。
我想問個律師，你聽到嗎？
聽到，請說。
律師呢，現在我的租客呢，他就幫我打官司，你市府呢，為什麼找兩個免費律師跟他打，就拖了差不多兩年時間，
I'm very sorry about your situation. I know things have been very challenging both for tenants and for struggling landlords.
咁我首先想道歉，因為我都明白對我哋嘅租客同我哋嘅業主依一段時間咧，真係好辛苦啦，
係好艱難。
You know, as a lawyer, it's always been important for me that anyone who is involved in litigation be represented. And we've known that oftentimes landlords have lawyers, but very rarely do tenants have lawyers. And so this is why I have supported over the years making sure that both sides are represented, including tenants.
咁我身為做律師咧，我係任何人喺一個官司裏邊咧，我都覺得佢哋應該係有法律顧問嘅，係有法律代表嘅。咁好多時候咧，我哋嘅業主係有能力去請律師，咁我哋嘅租客係冇依一個能力，但係我係咁多年嚟都係好想兩邊都係有法律援助嘅。
One thing I'll mention when I was in the legislature is it was very important during this time period of pandemic and recession that we assist struggling tenants and landlords. And so this is why I helped to champion billions of dollars to go to tenants and landlords where the tenant hasn't been able to pay so that we make sure that the landlords get the rent that they are owed and due.
咁我都明白喺一個時間係好艱難。咁喺我做立法院嗰陣時候咧，我係有幫手通過咗好多錢去為我哋嘅租客可以交到佢哋遲咗嘅租嘅，咁令到我哋嘅業主亦都唔會受到咁大嘅傷害。
好，咁我哋或者請邱信福繼續咧講一講咧佢而家優先要處理嘅事務啊。即係成為市府律師之後。
So before the break, we were talking about my priorities as the new city attorney. I will say, in addition to fighting for civil rights and fighting to make sure that workers and consumers are protected, we're going through some very significant challenges as a city, and I want to make sure we use the role of the law to tackle those challenges, whether it be housing and homelessness, our existential climate crisis. Or I will also say that, you know, during this time period, city government has been dealing with a number of high profile issues involving corruption. And I want to make sure that our office, which had led the investigation on the recent corruption that we have exposed, that we continue to hold city government to the highest ethical standards.
咁我哋去commercial 之前咧，我哋喺度講緊我嘅priorities。咁我係好想尋找用法律咧去解決我哋城市面臨嘅好大嘅挑戰嘅。咁其中就係包括我哋嘅住屋啦，我哋嘅無家可歸者啦，同埋我哋嘅氣候嘅變化噶。咁我會繼續用去去。遵守我哋嘅市府裏邊嘅道德嘅標準係達到最高嘅水平嘅，因為我哋都知道依兩年嚟我哋嘅市府有幾個部門係發現有貪污嘅問題啦。咁我接任依一個位之前咧，我上一個Dennis Herrera 佢都有開始咗一個嘅調查嘅，咁我個辦公室會繼續。以一個調查去令到我哋嘅市府裏邊咧係冇任何腐敗嘅。
咁即係話如果我哋啲市民發覺如果有咩政府即係我哋市府嘅官員貪污嘅話，係咪可以向你去舉報咧？
係咯，
Absolutely. So our office has been responsible for a lot of the corruption investigation from this perspective of the city. And we work closely with the U.S. Attorney's Office, who've been able to move forward with arrests in this area. But if anyone has evidence of ongoing corruptions or illegal activities or fraud on behalf of anyone in the city, please contact our office. We certainly want to talk to you.
是啊，如果你有任何的貪污的證據呢，你可以帶來我們的辦公室，我們的辦公室呢就會去調查的。在我們現在的貪污那個調查裡面呢，我們是有和美國的律師呢是繼續去調查，去
合作
，同埋可唔可以講一講你辦公室個電話，同埋有冇中文嘅人士接聽嘅咧？識講中文嘅，
即係啲嘅翻譯嘅服務。
咁你可以打到去我哋嘅辦公室電話咧，係415-554-4653嘅，依一個係我嘅 direct 個 phone number。咁咧你可以打俾我，我會接到你嘅電話。如果你講中文嘅，你唔需要擔心。
係，咁又或者冇人聽嘅話，唔緊要嘅，留言都
得
嘅，
係啦。
留言講清楚你嘅電話或者你個貴姓名，咁佢哋你哋就會有人覆佢噶啦。好，咁我哋或者聽聽另外一位咧，就係黃女士啊，好耐都冇嚟。係黃女士。
係黃女士。
可能等得耐個頭收咗線都唔定，唔緊要，黃女士你可以再打過嚟嘅。
冇錯。
咁如果大家有問題嘅話咧，除咗打過嚟直播室，仲可以利用短信平台。
係650-382-2808，650-382-2808嘅。咁啊，有位聽眾就問啦，而家咧好多傷人搶劫暴力案件嘅增多，咁想問下市府律師啊，優信福點樣解決？咁但係可能亦都唔係佢哋部門可以係處理到嘅事，不如做乜聽聽佢嘅意見啦。
So again, robberies fall under the category of crimes, and that is under the purview of the district attorney. One thing, though, we are looking into is when there are robberies. So, for example, we've seen a lot of retail theft at drugstores like Walgreens or neighborhood businesses. We know that those stolen goods go somewhere. They're very likely being fenced on commercial websites, online properties. We could bring a lawsuit against a major online marketplace if they are engaged in stolen goods. So again, we can't prosecute the crime, that's within the DA's office, but there are other tools that we have to go after certain types of wrongdoing in the civil context.
咁又講翻一次咧，就係、是偷嘢咧，就算係行刑嗰邊嘅，咁我哋係冇依一個權利去執行嘅。咁我哋 但系我哋睇到咧就系、是、所偷咗嘅嘢喺 Walgreens 啊，佢哋偷咗啲洗头水啊，或者刷啊牙膏啊，佢哋会去卖翻噶嘛。咁我哋见到有啲地方咧就系佢哋会上网去买嘅。咁、我哋其中可以做嘅嘢咧就系可以告呢一啲網站嘅業主。
嗯，有個聽眾咧，呢個問題非常之好啊，咁啊麻煩啦 ，Michelle 可以翻譯一下。佢就有個聽眾就話咧，就聽到就話三藩市而家罷免緊三位嘅教育委員啦，咁咧就話非公民都可以參與呢個罷免嘅投票，咁但係其實根據美國嘅憲法係應該成為公民先至有投票權噶，咁究竟係點嘅咧？大家都比較混亂，咁而家話非公民都可以去投票喎，咁。
So a number of years ago, the voters of San Francisco passed the ability for non-citizen immigrant parents to vote in school board elections. And the rationale for that is we have so many parents in our system that don't have a voice in selecting who are the school board members that are making the most important decisions in the, that affect the lives of their kids.
咁幾年前咧，我哋啲公民咧，佢哋係投票咗去俾我哋非公民嘅家長可以喺我哋BOE 我哋嘅教會嗰度咧，
教委
有得投票，有聲音可以發表佢哋嘅自己嘅反映自己想要嘅嘢。
咁、但係呢個就淨係三藩市一個嘅市嘅啫，其他都唔得嘅。咁依家聽眾就問到啦，咁會唔會違反咗聯邦法咧？將來會唔會令到我入籍嘅時候會被控或者被拒咧
？Right, so One thing I should mention is throughout our country's history, for about 150 years, immigrants were allowed to vote. Not something a lot of people know, but really until the 1920s, since the beginning of our country's formation, 1776, until a little bit after World War I, immigrants were allowed to vote under the theory that we want to engage our immigrant communities in civic activities. Now, this has not been the case for a number of decades, but in recent years, we have seen immigrants allowed to vote in a number of cities around the country. From my perspective, it is absolutely constitutional and legal. But there have been some questions depending on who's running the federal government, right? And when the law that we were just talking about first passed in 2016, it happened to be the same election when Donald Trump was elected. And so at that time, the city decided rather than create issues with the federal government to pause, delay the implementation of this for a couple of years. But now it is being rolled out, and I know that city officials are doing everything they can to make sure that we protect the sanctity of the right to vote.
好多人係唔知道咧，喺喺我哋嘅國家建立嗰陣時候咧，係有150年多嘅歷史咧，移民嘅咧可以係投票嘅。咁直至到我哋第一個世界大戰啦，1920年嗰陣時候咧，我哋嘅國家係好想去同我哋嘅移民嘅社區係有交接有交流嘅，咁但係因為世界大戰之後咧，好多嘅移民嘅社區俾人哋剝削咗佢哋嘅權利啦。咁依一個我哋嘅聽眾所講依一個法例咧，其實喺2016年係通過咗嘅，但係因為嗰陣時候係我哋嘅Donald Trump 係我哋個總統，咁我哋就係落咗一個決定，就係唔即刻去執行通過咗依一個法例嘅，咁我哋而家啱啱開始去執行啦，咁所以我哋明白有好多人有疑問，但係我自己嘅個人嘅感覺就係、是、俾我哋非公民嘅家長喺我哋教委裏邊嘅投票咧係完全係正確，亦都係合法嘅。
好，咁呢个时候咧就去一去广告先，再翻嚟咧就请阿邱顺福做一个总结。
服务湾区社群，关注世界大事，焦点访谈，
节目主持叶丽玲、麦长雄，节目直播热线650-808-8000，650-808-8000。
好啦，继续今日焦点访谈啊，话咁快嚟到最后一节啦吓。
嗯，冇错，咁我哋继续咧同阿邱瑞福倾倾啦，
系咯。咁如果大家有任何问题嘅，咁啊当然咧要尽快啦，啊把握时间啦。
诶，我哋有听众等咗好耐啦吓。
系，我哋或者听一听呢位听众先啦。啊，有啲咩问题请讲。
喂，婆婆啊，婆婆你试下先要将个电收音机校细佢先，会有好大嘅回音吓。
或者婆婆稍后先至打过嚟都可以。咁啊，跟住落嚟咧，咁啊要都请翻阿邱顺福啦，同我哋讲一讲啦。咁啊，继续落嚟啦。咁啊，对于我哋嘅社区会有啲咩特别嘅政策啊，或者有咩特别嘅行动咧？
So, you know, this year, obviously, we are still hopefully on the tail end of the pandemic. And what I would say is there are really three things that we should all be focused on. First, how do we keep everybody healthy? And how do we keep everybody safe to make sure everyone is vaccinated and boosted and masked and putting in all the protocols in place? I am so proud that Chinatown and the Chinese community has really been leading vaccination rates, has had the lowest level of COVID-19 transmission, in part because our community has been so careful. And our community leaders, Chinese hospital organizations have been really, really great in this area. The second thing we need to do is to make sure that our small businesses don't go under during this time. And I really want to thank so many members of the community that have been doing business with our small Chinese restaurants, our smaller businesses, to make sure that they thrive. I've actually worked to get billions of dollars of relief to small businesses with small business grants during this time period.
咁喺我哋嘅希望喺我哋呢個疫情尾聲嘅期間咧，我哋有兩樣嘢一定要做嘅，就係繼續保護我哋嘅社區係安全啦，亦都係健康。咁喺呢一個期間，我好開心咧，係見到我哋嘅華埠係有一個最高嘅疫苗接種率啦，同埋最低嘅傳播率嘅。咁我哋一定要繼續去幫助我哋嘅小商業啦，尤其是我哋嘅餐館。我好想多謝我哋嘅聽眾一路去幫助去支持我哋嘅唔同嘅企業嘅。我喺立法嗰個期間咧，亦都通過咗好多嘅資助咧，去幫我哋嘅小商業噶。
And I think in addition to protecting us from the health crisis and the economic crisis, our community, we have to continue to fight the anti-Asian hate that we see. And there's so much that we need to do. I mentioned before in the legislature, we fought to get more money to address this, but I'm also doing what I can to work with community leaders and others to make sure that our Asian community, that we have a voice on these issues, that we are protected. And as a first Asian city attorney, you know, I know that our community has been targeted, not just during this time period, but in many time periods throughout our country's history. And I would say it's why it's so important for our community to speak up, to demand safety, to make sure that we have representation and that we are getting true equality and fairness from government at this time.
咁我亦都好想確保我哋嘅亞裔社區咧，有發言權嘅。咁我作為一個第一個華人嘅士夫律師，我係好敏鋭到意識到我哋嘅社區歷史上咧，喺一個國家係一個攻擊嘅目標嘅，做過好多次。咁我哋一定要保障我哋嘅社區嘅安全，就係要我哋嘅社區係有代表嘅。
嗯，好，咁有位听众咧就好快咁想问翻呢个问题咧，佢话毒品嘅危害咧人人皆知，点解仲要大麻合法化，成立毒品安全注射室咧？咁成立咗之后，周边嗰啲治安亦都系一个问题嚟嘅，咁。
嗯。So these are complicated issues, and what I always say is important here is that we look to the science and we look to data. This has been important during this pandemic, and I think it's important during a conversation of how do we grapple with drugs.
咁我第一樣想反映咧，就係我哋係要睇翻我哋嘅科學家同埋我哋嘅數據嘅數據，去話俾我哋聽呢啲嘢係有幫助嘅，我哋應該去嘗試去睇下嘅。
What we have seen in recent years is that addictions to opioids has been an incredible crisis. This is why my office, we have lawsuits as we speak against the manufacturers and the distributors and the retailers related to opioids. This is also why we are looking at different innovative policies that we can do in this area. Around the world, there have been policies put in place known as safe consumption sites, which says that for individuals who are addicted to these, we want to get them into public health facilities. And so so the concept is to bring them into spaces where there are trained public health counselors and clinicians who can help these individuals. These sites have been incredibly effective at being able to provide care, and is something that is being contemplated as we speak in San Francisco.
咁我想反映嘅就係、我明白喺我哋三藩市裏邊同埋成個美國咧，係有好多人咧係迷患咗opioids
鴉片
嘅。咁我哋係有公司係去告翻依啲製造商啊同埋去嘅賣家嘅。咁我哋見過喺歐洲嘅國家裏邊咧，依啲嘅 safe consumption site 安全注射中心咧係有好嘅反應嘅，因為我哋可以帶到依啲嘅迷患者去一個公眾嘅地方，係有我哋嘅social worker 我哋有counselor 去幫佢哋揾保嘅幫助，去幫佢哋去平穩穩定翻佢哋嘅生活嘅。
講起呢個話題咧，可能咧都要請阿邱順福下一次再上過嚟啦，因為節目時間所限啦。咁啊，知道好多聽眾都關心呢個話題嘅。
冇錯。
今日節目時間到此為止啦，多謝曬阿邱順福上到嚟。
OK， 好快
有。Thank you for coming.
Thank you so much for coming. Good to see everyone. Happy New Year.
Yeah.
好希望好快又再見啦嚇。
Hope to see you again. Bye.
I'm always happy to come back.
Bye.
以上节目发表的言论纯属个人观点，并不代表星岛中文电台的立场。